the second I met Peter and was explaining to him what was in my heart and mind, I instantly loved the man. You know, I'm a bit of a sap, so I'm probably going to cry my eyes out. I've seen the movie a million times, and it still gets to me. But in telling Peter the story, he just was a kindred spirit in the way that he felt about the themes of the film and what I was going for. And he's such a beautiful writer and a beautiful director, and I feel really blessed to, you know, have him in my life and to have made an amazing movie. So. I think Timothy represents really anything is possible, and change is a good thing, and that, you know, I think he represents a different perspective for people in small towns everywhere and big cities everywhere. Being different is cool in my book. It's a long process to make a movie, and they've been great partners every step of the way, and I'm just, I mean, look, we're here, we have a green carpet, we made a, hopefully people will agree with me, I think we made a great movie, and I couldn't be happier, I'm all smiles.
One of the things I love about this movie is that it doesn't exist anywhere else besides this movie. It's not a remake. It's not a sequel. There aren't any special effects. It wasn't a book. It's just a movie that Peter Hedges and Amit Zappa came up with. And we're so lucky to be a part of it because this is exactly as it's supposed to be. It's filled with incredible realism when it comes to relationships, when it comes to parenting and family and husband and wife relationships, but then it's all wrapped up in a little magical bow. Timothy obviously changes his parents' life because he shows up fully formed as a 10-year-old and they become first-time parents of a 10-year-old overnight. So they go through this enormous journey discovering who they are, you know, all their ideas of who they thought they would be as parents, of course, are never what you think they're going to be. And then beyond that, he changes the whole town because the whole town learns acceptance. They learn less judgment. He's comes along without any irony or any sarcasm, and it kind of softens everyone. And I have to say, C.J. Adams, who played Timothy, he's exactly the same way. And when you're around him, you can't help but want to be calmer, nicer, sweeter. Audiences can expect to see themselves reflected back to them. Sometimes magic is a good way into to learning something about yourself. And I know that, you know, I saw this movie with two of my best mom friends. They're here with me somewhere tonight. And they cried and cried because they recognized themselves. But then their 10-year-old, one of them had a 10-year-old son with her, and he thought the movie was for him. And said, why are you guys crying? What's so emotional? Because, it is. But even the young men who have seen it have walked in and said, wow, that made me have a little, I had a little tear. So it's life affirming. It's like an old fashioned Disney film.
I mean, this movie reminds me of E.T. and Big and It's a Wonderful Life. You know, it's like real life. Seen under the microscope but through a sprinkling of magic dust. It's a completely open-hearted movie that kind of is unafraid to kind of just look at what's going on now with us, with family and with industry, and I don't know, Peter's a very special man. He's told a very great story. Well, that's why I think we really relate to these stories. It's like a town is as it is, behaving as it was, with its own problems, all the people within it. And then this magical stranger kind of comes to town and changes everybody's lives and inevitably maybe has to go. But he's everything that Jennifer and I dream up as characters in the story, honest to a fault, and stands for the character trait to love and be loved. I think audience can expect a really warm feeling. I call it the happy cry. You know, that there's a sort of a happy sadness to it. I think they could expect maybe to go home with something in their pocket, you know, to really reflect what's going on in their own life, you know, because they look at this town, but it's sort of a parallel maybe to their own universe.
Well, he definitely changed everyone's lives, but what I think was most important that he taught everyone hope, and that if you believe what you can do, and if you think you can do that memory or whatever you were going to do, you can do that. Well, what's great about Peter is that I knew him in my first movie, Dan in Real Life, so it made it really easy for me to act around him. He's just so sweet and an amazing director. Probably what most audiences will like about this film is how different it is and how it teaches hope. And like I said before, it's just so unique and different, and everyone will love that.
It's absolutely a magical film. I think that's a great way to put it. It's beautiful. It has, I think, a really kind of timeless tale, something that people of all ages can relate to. It's extremely touching, and it took me back to some, reminded me of books and stories, and it's sort of the Disney of old that I remember growing up and loved. So thrilled to be part of this project, and really hope that people enjoy it.
I think it's very clean, it's very polished. It covers every issue. The inability to conceive your own children, that's always been a big issue. The environment, helping the environment with going green, rivalry between sisters, just so many issues it covers. So I think everyone can relate to it, but what makes it such an incredible movie is the magical element. And it kind of, it makes you love movies again, family movies again. He makes people realize that life is bigger than what they think it is. It's more than just having a perfect child, or more than just winning, or more than just having this coldness about yourself. I mean, he opens people up. He brings them together. I think they expect just a sweet movie, to something that will make you laugh and cry. And I'm saying, like, you will laugh and cry. I've seen the movie with people. You will laugh and cry. I think that's what they're expecting.
Absolutely. It's sort of a fable, isn't it? And what I love about it is I think it really falls in the tradition of the great Disney movies. I think of the ones I grew up with, Little Mermaid. That was my jam when I was a kid. And to be a part of, you know, a really classic Disney film, I'm really thrilled. Yeah, I think audiences can expect to laugh and to cry. The movie really sneaks up on you and packs an emotional wallop by the end, so I'm really proud of it, and that's a real testament to Peter Hedges.
La película de verdad que es increíble, te hace reír, te hace llorar, y se trata de familias, las familias que creamos, no solo las familias que tenemos, pero los que creamos y las comunidades que creamos.
It reminds me a little bit of Pinocchio, you know, it's sort of a callback to the a magical boy. I mean, all kids are kind of magical. I think Timothy's sort of especially magical in that they don't quite know where he comes from, and they're not quite sure where he's going. But
it's grounded in something I think everybody can relate to, is wanting to start a family. You know, and I think it's great to have the magical boy element, but it's also a very real story about a couple who is just desperate to start their family. I think that he really opens everyone's eyes to what kind of job they're doing with their own kids, and what it, we, in this world of over-parenting and scheduling your kids' days within an inch of their lives, I think it really speaks to the power of love and just wanting a child, and that that's enough.
Yeah, Timothy's not really concerned about what he's supposed to be. He's just kind of who he is, and I think that has an effect on everybody around him.
We were trying to make one of those movies that you watch over and over again, hopefully, that you go back to. Field of Dreams, E.T., were some models of possibility, or It's a Wonderful Life. We just wanted to make a film that would make you laugh and break your heart and remind you what's most important. What does he bring? I think he brings the kind of wisdom that many kids possess that we don't necessarily notice or recognize because we think they're just kids. He's not precocious, he's not obnoxious, but he's innately wise, and I think he helps them find the proper perspective and helps them find balance. What I hope they'll get, and what we found that they're getting, is that they'll laugh that kind of great laugh of, oh, I know those people, and they'll see how absurd we can be as people. And even when we're doing the best we can, we make some pretty wild mistakes. So my hope is that it's one of those stories that leaves you wanting to, you know, really go out and live and celebrate life.
Well, Amit Zappa is the one who came up with the idea, and in the showers, he'll tell you, and I think that is all very true, and then he connected with Scott Sanders, who then connected with Peter, and they began the process. I came in later in the process, and reading the first draft of it was like, it's just a beautiful, emotional story. It was very original, really unique, from the start of the idea to the what it becomes and how it evolves and kind of the twists and turns that it takes. So I felt like, you know, you're fortunate to be involved with something that feels unique and at the same time has a beauty to it and an artfulness to it. And then Peter just did a wonderful job of taking what was there and that he wrote and just having it come out visually. So it's really a great experience. Yeah, it's really great.
It really is fun to see the music come to life on the screen. I just, this one came together in such a great way. It's such a beautiful movie, and it's one I'm proud to be a part of. And really, it's, you know, usually I like to leave a movie and feel like it's better because I was there. But this movie, I feel like a better person because it was there for me. So it's really, really been a great experience for me all the way around. See, Peter Hedges is just a lovely human being. He means every word of everything he writes. He means everything, you know, in the way he directs, and you can really feel like how